Hello guys and welcome back. Today in this video we're going to make the second part of the masts. This is, as you remember, the first part. I have all the way up to the platform. This piece is not glued yet. So now what we're going to make is the second part. More precise, the part that goes through this hole here, all the way here and up to, I don't know, somewhere right here. As before, I'm going to work at the three masts at the same time, but I'm only going to film the first mast, the main mast, I'm sorry. So this is, as you can see here, the middle part of the main mast. So let me gather my materials, find out what this piece is, and I'll get back to you. And I have them, guys. The front mast and the main mast are 8 millimeters in diameter, and the rear mast is 5 millimeters diameter. So like before, this is 5 millimeters, so it's easy to cut, no problem with that. That's it. Would not throw away anything. Let's make sure that this was the piece that I need. It must be 194, it is, millimeters. Now, for the other two, I'm going to use the saw, because, like I said, it's 8 millimeters, so maybe it will be damaged. Just some sanding. Now, let's see what we have to work with. These holes, this is 8 millimeter, this hole is not 8. If I remember correctly, it's smaller. So we have this and this one to make it go pass through here. Also this one must go pass through here. Definitely there's a mistake in the holes and I will explain why. These are at the startup, so at the startup they must be at the exact length that at the beginning, as you can see here, this is the beginning of the, this will go like this, so the thickness, the diameter must be equal to the hole, and it must get thinner as it goes all the way to the top. So I probably have to open up these holes just a little bit for this to pass through. So let me do that with the same usual way and I'll get back to you. I have them, as you can see, 8 millimeters and it's through. Also this one is 5 millimeters and it's through. easy stuff. Just remember to use the power drill in reverse. Now, let me find out, let me get the other pieces, because these masts will join the top, the third part of their mast with the same pieces like this one. So let me get them, because they are prefixed. Let me clean them and I'll get back to you. Now guys, let me explain something to you. I've opened up the holes like you saw just a moment ago. Here we have 8 millimeters. This is 8 millimeters, and all the way up here must be 6. So this little piece must be 6 millimeters, and this hole right here, the big one, the small one, I don't care about it yet, it's 5, so I have to make it 6. Also, I have to make these two 6, so I have to make these two 6. This one's here is 5 millimeters, it's okay, and all the way up here must be 4. This hole is 5, so as you can see, it's bigger already. So I must make this 4, but I won't touch this one, because I'm going to have a problem. It's not a problem to glue it, but if I touch it and make it bigger, I'm going to have definitely a problem to make it steady. So let's start by making these two 6 millimeters. They are 5. So the first thing I have to do is make them 5.5. So this is the 5.5, this is the 6. In reverse, and let's begin. As you see, the piece broke, but I can glue it. So let me glue that, let me fix the other one, and I'll get back to you. Now, I have the 3 pieces, guys. I had one small accident here, but nothing to worry about. As you can see, I've fixed it, it's okay. Also, I have the other piece, and I have rounded up the holes to this piece here. Now, what's needed to be done now is to make this thinner. If you remember, we start here at 8 millimeters, you have to end up here at 6 millimeters. The procedure is exactly the same as before, nothing changes. I will have to protect the piece of wood, because now I do not want to have any marks. If you remember previously, here I had marks, but I don't care. These are going inside the ship, so no one will be able to see it. But these are on the outside, so I do not need any marks. Or at least, I need as small marks as I can. Now, let's see where we stand. is the main mast. And I have it. As you can see, beautiful. Now, let me do the others and I'll get back to you. Before proceeding to the next step, I wanted to show you something, guys. These are the platforms for the between the second and third part of the mast. As you can see, they are metal and prefixed. Of course, definitely they were going to be painted brown, but what I have to show you is that these are the holes where the mast should go, and they were a little bit smaller, so I had to open them up. These are 6mm holes, as you can see, they go through. Don't need to go through all the way, because as you can see here, I have to place it approximately at this height, so no need to do that for the entire mast. And just that, I want to show you that you had to open the holes. So these parts are easier. So let me see what these are, and I'll get back to you, because I believe these are going to be needed to sand them, to sand them down and make it round. So I'm going to need to place it over here to be able to sand it out through the drill. We will see. So let me find out what these are and I'll get back to you. Now, guys, here we have some pieces that will be the platform, the base of the platform. This is where the platform will lie on, exactly right here. These are going to be made by these pieces of wood. This is a walnut, it's 2x3, and I have to cut them in a specific length. I believe it's 15mm, if I remember correctly. And I have to, as you can see here, to make it thinner as it goes all the way. Here it starts at 2mm and here it ends at 1mm. That's not difficult to do. Just to make a point here, this is the main mast. This is the second part of the main mast. Definitely this goes here. It's not going to be glued on yet. And this goes here. Because I believe I'm going to need to sand down this by putting it inside the power drill, it's better to place this piece right here, right now. Also this one, because later it's going to be hard. So let me cut these pieces in size and I'll get back to you with the assembly. Well, guys, these are the pieces. They are 15mm in length. I had to cut 30 of them, because according to the plans I need 12 here. I believe there are too many, 12 at the other one right here, and 6 at the small one. I believe 12 are too many, but we're going to find out together. Now, as you can see here, I have made the marks, some marks here, where this must be, must go. Let me clean up the lower one, not need that. And let's place the first one. Let me see something. Okay. Just let me check a picture to make sure about something, and I'll get back to you. Now, I check the picture, I'm pretty sure about what I'm going to do, and I'm continuing. Many here, not a problem. So let me cut this piece. Let's do it less in half. Let's see if it fits. The lower part is okay, the upper part needs some sanding. That's it. Everything will be sanded down, so nothing to worry about. Some glue here. The first thing I have to do is make this piece here even with the others. So let's cut this excess part. It was very easy, as you can see. Now, I have one little correction up here to make. What I need to do now is, first of all, make this round because it's rough, and secondly, make the lower part thinner. That's what we're going to do with the power drill. Let me get that and I'll get back to you. Now, you have to be very careful. And I've got it. Let me get some focus. As you can see, at the top it's thicker than the bottom. Perfect. Now, the next step. The next step is to place the platform. This platform. This one goes like this. Let me check that it's straight. It is. So now we glue. And now it's time to place it on the main mast. First of all, let's check the height. This little piece must be exactly in here. needs more. It's exactly inside, as you can see, it's perfect. Now, what I have to do is make this one to be aligned with the lower one. Let me move the camera and we'll do it together. So this piece must go like this. I believe I have it. So let me glue it and I'll get back to you. Now, if you remember, we have two pieces here that we're going to go over here, but first what I needed to do is to glue one piece with the other. So these pieces must go like this, and after that, I must sand it down to have a curve, like a small hill. So, before doing that, I'm going to cut the edges to make it easier for me to sand it. Let's glue it. I will let the glue dry for a moment and I'll get back to you to do the sanding. Now, it's a little bit difficult, but let's see. This, believe it's better. And here we are, just some smoothing now with some sandpaper and it's ready. So the next thing to do is to paint this brown and we move on to the final piece of, as you can see, it's very long, this is the main mast, and we'll move on to the final piece, which is the third part of the mast. I also have to do the other two, of course, you understand. So, thanks again for watching, guys. See you soon with the next phase where we complete the woodwork on the mast. Thanks again.